To all who come to this happy place, welcome.
Good morning. Welcome to my vlog, and thank you for joining me this morning. It's Monday, and it's about 7:45 here, almost 8 o'clock. I'm just going to be eating my breakfast, which consists of a bowl of Greek yogurt and granola, as well as orange juice. So last night, Megan got home from her spring break, so welcome back, all of you spring breakers. Yeah, it was fun, and we went to a birthday party. One of her roommate's brother had a Keurig, but he's not into coffee or anything, so it was great. I was like, I will gladly take it off your hands. So I did, and got a Keurig last night, as well as the groceries, which I felt like one of the people from, like, World's Strongest Men, like the metrics World's Strongest Men, carrying those extremely heavy things. That's what I felt like carrying the groceries in, because it was a long distance for carrying groceries. So got that in, and then that was added to my morning routine, because I was like, my main point of having a coffee machine is just so I can have something extra in the morning to wake me up and stuff, and it helped. But still, just getting back into the groove after spring break and after like all that stuff. I didn't really do spring break or anything because I'm not in school right now, but that's just how it is. So I tried French vanilla coffee creamer for the first time in a while. I can remember now why I haven't been using it. I've been using hazelnut just because it tastes better and everything, and I gotta get some more hazelnut creamer. But anyway, I'm gonna be going to work in a little bit once I eat and finish getting ready and stuff. Oh, what a day. So, wow, yeah, you can tell. I just finished showering a little bit ago. Yeah, my voice is a little bit gone. It was a good day. Very long, hence I did not get to do an afternoon portion of this vlog. Very, very, very sorry about that. But this makes my job a little bit easier because it's less video to edit. But I just wanted to share something with you guys first off by saying thank you for watching. Just because I've had more positive feedback on my videos than anything else, which is always a great thing. I'd rather get like some kind of, not just positive feedback, but constructive criticism. That's the best thing that I can possibly ask for, just the support in that way. It's always a wonderful thing. Also, at work today, I left a little bit early just because Megan came and I had to fax something for her. Which, by the way, HelloFax.com, great site. If you guys ever need to fax anything and don't actually have the papers or whatever, but they're online somewhere or you have them in digital form, just upload them to HelloFax.com and you can fax them anywhere for free. So that's what I did. But Apple event happened today. I felt like there was like 4 new phones. I don't think there were 4 new phones. I think it was just one phone. The iPhone 5e or 6e, 6se, I can't remember. So in case you guys didn't actually get to see the Apple event today, and you know what I'm talking about, but it's a 4-inch phone. So they're taking it back a little bit as far as inches that you're having to hold in your hand, because this is the iPhone 5S. It's not cracked or anything, it's just a decal. I have it on both. Smaller, obviously, in terms of height than the 6 or 6S, but it's also thicker. The GPU, graphics processing unit, is 3 times faster in this newest phone that's coming out on Thursday than that phone that I just showed you, than the 5S. The overall speed of the phone is literally about twice as fast as that phone. It was a pretty good presentation. Very short. It was only like an hour because they were just very cut to the point. They started off by showing what they're doing for the environment and what they're doing medically. Some advances in the medical field that they have tapped into. They also showed off the campus, which the new like spaceship looking campus, it's huge and it looks amazing. It's supposed to open up next year, which is incredible. It's just going to be a huge improvement. But they're also coming out with a smaller iPad Pro, basically allowing you to take the Apple Pencil and utilize this new iPad Pro like it's just a piece of paper, except it's digital and you can store stuff on it. So much more versatile than just having a notebook. All kinds of people use it. I know that John Lasseter was featured on there. He wasn't there, but they featured him because he is the chief creative officer, the CCO of, I think, Disney and Pixar, or both, whichever one. I'm sorry, John Lasseter, if you're watching this, can't remember. But they featured him because he's a very avid user of the iPad Pros, just because it's something that's, again, so versatile and very flexible and very reliable. And also, it looks really nice, so that's just an added little side feature. But I've seen him in videos and stuff that he'll interact with his coworkers and stuff that work with him. He'll interact with them on the way to work or just going around, whatever, like on his commute, and it's very interesting stuff. So I'm looking forward to it. They're coming out with like all kinds of really cool things. things, which is the gist of what most people say when they don't work in IT. But being that I work in IT, we make kind of a big deal out of it because most of the products we use are Apple products because we're very pro-Apple. We're not like anti-Windows or anything, but we're very pro-Apple where I work. So yeah, so anyway, it was shoulder day at the gym. It was a good day. It was a great workout. I got some editing here to do. I've been on this Disney's new game for mobile called Magic Kingdoms. I got the name wrong last time I mentioned it. It was Magical Kingdoms, but it's called Disney's Magic Kingdoms, and it was made by Gameloft. They have done a great job of just being able to give you the experience of building your own Magic Kingdom, your own version of Magic Kingdom, the park in Walt Disney World, in the style of Roller Coaster Tycoon. It's kind of the same idea. You don't like build the tracks or anything of the roller coaster. It's the rides and the attractions and everything in the shows are already pre-made. You just kind of place them, do whatever you want with them, and you level your characters up and stuff. It's really cool. A lot of fun. Very great at teaching multitasking, and also it could take like 12 hours for Goofy to eat a sandwich. It's kind of weird. Someone will take a nap for about 30 seconds and I'm like, I don't know what's going on there. So anyway, but yeah, that's just my review for the day. Thanks again guys for watching, and have a great night. See ya.